Hello everyone, welcome to Worldline PayTech Bytes. I'm your host Pritish. In this episode, we deep dive into the latest finding and trends from Worldline India Digital Payments Report for H1 2024. For this conversation, we have with us Mr. Sunil Rongala, who is the Senior Vice President, Strategy, Innovation and Analytics at Worldline, who is joining us virtually today. Sunil, welcome to the show.
Hi Pritish, thank you.
Sunil, we have been publishing this report for past 6 years now. Could you briefly share some of your observations on the evolution of our payment industry over these years?
So, I think the biggest... when we started this report in 2018 or so, UPI was almost nothing. And now UPI has become this with 14 billion plus transactions a month. So that is the biggest change that has happened in the 6 years. The other change that has happened is that at one point of time, if you looked at the card transactions, debit card transactions in terms of value itself were almost 50-50 when you compared it to credit card. So debit card was really on the up and up. And now you're seeing a substantial difference both in terms of transactions as well as the number of transactions, as well as the total value of the transactions, both on POS as well as e-commerce. So those three things, I think, are the biggest change that we've seen, apart from the fact that, you know, we've seen net banking was always there. And then if you look at in terms of mobile uptake also in the last 6 years, there's been a significant uptake in the mobile. And lastly, if you look at the ETC, ETC transactions used to be fairly anemic. But once the government started mandating that all vehicles, four-wheelers at least, have ETC tags, you're seeing the number of ETC tags issued as well as the transactions of ETC just continuously growing, you know, every month, and like we say, every half year, it's growing at a tremendous pace.
Okay. So what are some of the key findings from our latest India Digital Payments Report for H1?
So the key findings that if you have to look at it is, one, the number of point of sale terminals has increased fairly rapidly. It has now touched 8.96 million, about to hit 9 million. And one of the reasons for that is obviously the RBI's PIDF. And then what we're also seeing is that, from what we've been observing from previously, is that there's been a steady decline in the debit card transactions. But on the other side, you see credit card transactions increasing fairly continuously, indicating how for large high value transactions that credit cards is the preferred method of spending. But it's not a big guess, but UPI has really what really caught by surprise is that if you look at UPI transactions in terms of just, you know, they have a humongous base. You're seeing transactions grow at some 40-50% year on year, which is like any other, no other payment channel in the world has that. Nothing comes closer to that if you look at it globally. Yeah. And the other biggest surprise is how P2M transactions have been driving this growth, which is P2M is payments for goods and services to merchants. And that is seeing a phenomenal, it already was higher than P2P transactions, but that you're seeing a growth of 60% plus, both in terms of transactions and volume. So that to me is a real story. And obviously, you know, look at average ticket size as sort of the benchmark for how ingrained a payment channel is. And you're seeing the average ticket size falling for P2M specifically. It's already, you know, it's about 640 or so. And basically indicating that UPI is now continuously being used for micro transactions, that's, you know, 100 and below kind of transactions. And that's really what is driving up the... So what is the interesting bit also is that the number of transactions that are being done on UPI is actually much higher than the value. So that's, if you look at it in terms of percentage thing. So essentially that you're using it for 10 rupee transactions, 20 rupee transactions. Like I said, during the press conference, I recently used UPI for 10 rupees to enter into a railway platform. So you're using it across the board for like small transactions. A lot of us don't keep cash itself in our pocket itself, maybe, you know, for emergencies. But UPI is from 10 rupees to 1,000 rupees or 2,000 rupees. We're using UPI across the board.
Correct. You know, these trends, especially the UPI for, you know, micropayments, you know, it shows the rapid integration of digital payments in our everyday life. Actually, even I don't use cash much. So every small payment, we use UPI only for buying bread and everything. So it is, you know, gone that micro nowadays, which is a good sign.
No, you mentioned UPI Lite for the microtransaction. That's really transformed in terms of the sort of frictionless payments that we talk about. That to me is the real sort of, you know, because all you do is it's in three steps. You open the app, you scan, you enter the amount, hit enter, and you're done with the transaction. It literally takes some 4 or 5 seconds. So the frictionless sort of thing and is really driving microtransactions on UPI.
Correct. Any final thoughts for viewers, Sunil?
So I think I would be one of the questioners from the Economic Times asked about some things for us to look out for. And I think in the report also we've talked about the unified lending interface. That's something that, you know, I'm keen to see how that actually pans out as we're going forward. Then some of the compliance things that we're talking about now in terms of the in-store being bought under the RBI's regulatory ambit. And so that's something that, you know, is good to look out for. I'm also keen to see how UPI on credit, that's, and UPI delegate payments, the new thing that NPCI launched during GFF. I'm keen to see how that actually takes off, because I see a huge need for it. So I think we will see a fairly good uptake on both those and driving UPI transactions pretty much even more. So I think those are some of the things to look forward to. But the report has, in the report, we talked a bit about there's an article on ULI, which I think is worth reading into to see how that could potentially, if there's an uptake for that, how it could potentially change the lending industry itself in India, as well as UPI delegate payments. But, you know, we will continuously see UPI kind of grow. When we come to the next report, I won't be surprised if we see another, you know, YOY increase of 50-60%.
Okay. Thank you, Sunil, for your valuable insights today. Viewers, a link to download the full report will be provided in the description below. Join us for the next episode of Worldline PayTech Bytes with another fascinating topic and guest. Please like, share and subscribe. See you next time. Thank you.
Thank you, Pritesh.